Það er bara skemmtilegt.
Hi, my name is Aethys. I work as an animator slash 3D artist here at Mirkur Games. I picked up how to do hair for 3D characters when I got here because we didn't have the mocap equipment yet. So we bought a course from John Lithwell and he taught me a thing I drew about hair. To start with, we take like reference photos of the model in case we have Aethys here, our main character, Rin. And she has curly hair, so I start looking at different sorts of curly hair and styles. Yeah, I study how the hair flows and how it works, what sort of like length it is, and what sort of styles work with her face. And I start taking like different photos of people I find on Pinterest with hair I like, and I start like mixing and matching them to Aethys's photo to make all of these sort of different styles. And then I ask for opinions from the team and try and narrow down like what they like, what they think like goes with her head. And then I end up with a board of like different styles that people pick from. In Aethys's case, it was a ponytail. My next step was to get her back in and take new reference photos of her with ponytail in her hair. These are the photos. And I use them to match her hair like perfectly when I start placing it onto the model. That's so creepy. So when I have like a rough idea of what I'm going to do with her, I get her in a third time and I take reference photos like of her actual hair, like just a white blank piece of paper, and I layer her hair on top of it just to get like the texture. So I whip off this sort of board, which gives me an idea of what my texture card will look like. And we need like thick chunks, and we need flyaways, and we need like different sort of like root materials and stuff. And when I have this down, I take it into Maya and I create an X-Gen description. Like, X-Gen is, it makes realistic looking hair, but the problem with X-Gen is that you get individual hairs, like pieces, like strands of hair. That's way too expensive for like Unreal and game engines. So what I need to do is create my hair in X-Gen and then bake it down. And this geometry, I bake into textures and texture cards. The way to place hairs, there's no like magic generation type of thing going on here. You just need to place it by hand and bend it, and yeah, that's the only way to make it look really good. You want to have some of these like bigger, thicker chunks that have like, no transparent gaps in them. Like this one. So this is the base there. Doesn't look like much. Looks really creepy. It looks like a cap on your head, but that's just for covering the bases. The next layer is like composed of these like more transparent ones. Flyaways are like really important, and that's why we need a lot of these like small curly bits. What I did here is that I used like the original reference photos of Aethys, and I put them into Maya. When we have like the actual structure complete, it's time to place it in Engine. When we've got her in Engine, it's a matter of like tweaking the shaders, the shader of the hair. This is my end result right here, but I might end up tweaking it even more. But as you can see, it sort of like behaves naturally. Every type of hair works differently, so you have to think about like how much shine does it have, what's the color like. Palette, like, is it darker in the roots? Is it like purple? You can change so many things, and it's down to like commas on how accurate you need things to be. So I could tweak this for days and get different results for different things. So an important thing to keep in mind is to use like real references all the way through your process. Just keep looking at real photos of the real thing you have, and if you don't have photos of like your exact model, then just find similar people with similar hair and use that, because building on top of reality is always better than just going along with your own creational process, because we can't make up what we don't fully understand. That was like real-time hair for game characters. Thanks for tuning in.